But we are going to have to grapple with the problems that man has been grappling with through history. But man didn't force us to grapple with these problems. The Bible demands that we grapple with them. Man, for years now, have been talking about war and peace. But no longer can they just talk about it. No longer is it a choice between violence and nonviolence. It's nonviolence or nonexistence. Also, in the human rights revolution, if something isn't done to bring the colored people of this world out of their long years of poverty and out of their long years of despair, this whole world is doomed. If I lived in Russia, or even China, or any authoritarian government, maybe I can understand the denial of certain basic First Amendment privileges, because they haven't committed themselves to that over there. But somewhere I read of the freedom of speech. Somewhere I read of the freedom of assembly. Somewhere I read of the freedom of press. Somewhere I read that the greatness of America is the right to protest for rights. So as I say tonight, we aren't going to let any injunction turn us around. Let us move up tonight to the stand ready. Let us move on to these powerful days, these days of struggle to make America a better nation. I don't know what's going to happen now. We've got some difficult days ahead, but I'm not worried about that. I just want to do God's people, and He's allowed me to go up to the mountain, and I look